Welcome to Formula One.
And I respect that. But my client has a championship to contest. So if you want our participation, I'm afraid the concessions are mandatory. Yes, that's fine. Get back to me when you can. Goodbye. No one ever just signs the contract. Anyway, thanks for coming by on such short notice. Just needed to cover a couple of quick things with you before you race. Firstly, as requested, there's a copy of your contract. It's a rolling deal. However, the team reserves right of termination if you fail to meet performance standards. You're second driver for now, but work hard, hit your targets, and I'll be able to sweeten the deal. I'm also looking to get you into some invitational events throughout the season. The experience and exposure from these will be great for your image. Plus, you're going to drive some nice historic cars. Now then, go get ready for the next session. And good luck.
Welcome to our viewers from around the globe. You join us just as today's practice session for the Australian Grand Prix is about to start. We can see, of course, plenty of activity in the garages as we wait for the green light to get this session underway. Anthony Davidson, thank you for joining me once again. What are you going to be looking out for once the cars get out there on the circuit today?
Well, naturally, in any free practice session, you can never be sure exactly what programs teams are running, how much fuel they've put in, and so on. So it's important to resist the temptation to draw any firm conclusions from the fastest times on the monitor. What we can do, however, is look for consistent pace over the course of multiple laps. So if someone does half a Grand Prix distance, and they're consistently half a second quicker than another driver doing the same, then that's generally a good indicator of a car with a solid race pace. In the unforgiving world of Formula One, free practice sessions are a vital part of any Grand Prix weekend. During your F1 career, you'll be able to utilise these sessions to complete practice programmes.
Good morning, Jeff here. Looking forward to working with you as your race engineer. Hope you've had a good night's sleep, as we've got a lot of work to do today to prep for the season ahead. We're ready to fire up the car, so why not head out and get a few laps under your belt?
Thank you.
tyres have set us back a little. At some point before qualifying, let's get our track acclimatization program complete. It'll help us identify any specific problem areas on the circuit. So far, our fastest lap is a 1:34.1.
As all the cars are now over the line, your top three again are Bottas, Raikkonen, and Sebastian Vettel. That concludes an interesting practice session. Let's hope for more excitement as the weekend unfolds.
Message. Perfect. Welcome to home away from home. We get more real-time data from the factory now than ever before, and it all comes through here. So I have to spend more time checking over the reports and less time hunting you down in the hospitality suite. To that end, sorry, just a sec. Yeah, Chris here, is this important? I'm in the middle of something. Okay. Right. Well, that makes no sense. Have Sarah reset the simulation and run it again. Okay. Sorry about that. As I was saying, we've set up a desk for you at the front here. You can get onto the network from your laptop, so make sure to check the R&D screen regularly. And let us know how you want to use the data that we've collected over the weekend and through the practice programs. Also, bear in mind that the news from the factory won't always be good. Sometimes tests fail, like you've seen just now. And when that happens, we have to divert additional resources to fix it. C'est la vie, I'm afraid.
Quick look at the classification at the end of the session then. Here are your top three. Hamilton, Vettel and Valtteri Bottas.
Hey, looks like you've got a bit of rivalry going on out there. This is good. Gets people talking about you. Just make sure you outperform them, okay?
Hi, it's Emma. Your qualifying goals came up in the board meeting this morning. Here's what to expect.
The track acclimatization program, available in free practice sessions, allows you to learn the track whilst earning resource points for the development of your car. On-track markers show the key points through each corner, and the more of these you're able to consistently drive through at an appropriate speed, the higher your score and the more resource points you'll be rewarded with. Try and chain together multiple successful corners for a consistency boost to your score. Consistency over a long distance is vital in Formula One, so being able to manage tyres and reduce tyre wear is a useful skill. The tyre management program available in free practice sessions will help you learn tyre management while earning resource points for development of your car. Be careful on the controls to reduce the amount of tyre slip and therefore wear. The better you can do this, the higher you will score and the more resource points you'll receive. You'll need to balance tyre management with speed, as you must stay under the target lap time. When the on-screen bar moves towards the red end, that means that you're wearing your tyres more than expected at this part of the lap. When it moves towards the purple, you're wearing them less. Stay in the green or purple for a successful test. The qualifying pace program available in free practice sessions challenges you to beat a target time that corresponds to an expected position on the starting grid. Complete 3 flat-out laps on the fastest tyre compound to set the best time you can, and you'll earn resource points for hitting your target.
Welcome to Melbourne, where qualifying for the Australian Grand Prix should be getting underway shortly. Looking at this field today, Ant, do you think we're going to see anyone take a chance, maybe run the harder of the available compounds and save some of the grippy tyres for the race tomorrow?
Well, I'd be surprised in all honesty. It's only the front runners that really have the pace to get away with that. And even then, at the end of the day, it's a big risk. Track position is the most important thing, and it's rarely worth sacrificing for a slightly more optimal strategy in the race, so I doubt we're going to see anyone trying it. I have been wrong before, though. We certainly do see some risky decisions every now and then, and it's a gamble that's sometimes worth taking. But if it were me in the car, I would want to be on the fastest tyre for my qualifying lap, without a doubt.
There's only a few cars out on track. We should consider getting out.